Welcome back, Trader Troops. So, here to update you with Crypto.com. Of course, we are seeing a little bit of a dip today, along with Bitcoin. In fact, Crypto.com has been pretty correlated with Bitcoin, and we're going to get into that later in the video. Make sure to watch it all the way until the end. Of course, I'm going to run you down through my technicals today, show you where I think it's going, where I think it's headed. Make sure to smash up that like button and subscribe if you do enjoy the video, and hit the bell notification icon so you never miss another post, because I do post the latest and greatest cryptocurrency technical analysis on the internet in real time. It's very easy to miss my videos, so just make sure that bell notification icon is clicked and become a trader troop. All right, so let's take a look at crypto.com. The first thing that I want to show you guys is going to be on the weekly time frame, as always. Okay, what we're going to see on crypto.com is that we are still overbought, which is actually a bullish sign. If you remember from the last crypto.com video, as long as we can maintain this overbought zone, which I know it sounds contrary to popular belief, as long as we can maintain above 70 on RSI, it's actually a sign of strength, because it takes a lot of buying pressure in order to keep RSI overbought, right? If something is overbought and people are still managing to buy it, then that is a sign that people are really willing to buy whatever we're trading, right? So this is actually a bullish sign. It almost acts as a level of support in a way for both RSI and for price. If we drop down to a smaller time frame like the daily chart, we're going to see that we are still holding that 50% Fibonacci retracement level strong right in here, and that is from this low to this high. We can see we had a massive bull run off of that level there, which is a great sign of confirmation of a possible lower or a higher low being formed, right? Uptrends are made of higher highs and higher lows. We have a higher high. Now let's try to get that higher low, right? So that is a good sign that we see right there. If we take a look at the daily RSI, we're also going to see that we are currently kind of hovering around that 50 level. If you don't know if you can stay above the 50 level on RSI, then you are technically in an uptrend. Right now, we're right in the middle of it, so I'm not going to say we're in an uptrend or a downtrend, but just the fact that we saw this little bounce on RSI in this general 50 area, the midpoint of the RSI, is also another good sign. So let's drop down to a lower time frame and get into the nitty-gritty. So let's go into something like the 4-hour chart, okay? So once we drop down to the 4-hour chart, we're going to see a few things, okay? We're going to see that this level of support held, right? We've already talked about that. Now we're also going to see that we bounced off that level of support with a lot of strength. We can see that right in here, and that tells us that we should technically have made a bottom in here, right? The buyers came in very, very strong, so we know that the buyers are pretty eager to jump into crypto.com. We do not see a lot of selling coming in here other than this area of resistance right in here, which is perfectly normal, right? We expect sellers to come in at areas of resistance. So what we said in the last video is that we expected a bounce at this general area right in here, right? We expected a pullback. We got that pullback into this area of support between 60 cents and 58 cents. We did, in fact, come into that area and bounce a little bit, but now we're seeing that area begin to fail, which is obviously not a great sign. Now, the fact of the matter is that I'm still very bullish on crypto.com, and just because we are breaking this little tiny level of support on the smaller time frames does not necessarily mean that we are bearish and that we're going to go into the end of the world apocalypse on crypto.com, right? So what I ended up doing is I just looked like maybe, you know, we just got that level of resistance wrong, because it is a very tiny level of resistance. And what I ended up seeing on the 4-hour chart is that we actually do have a larger time frame level of resistance that, in my opinion, makes more sense. And that is going to be this area right in here between 58 cents down to around 56 cents, okay? If you take a look to the left, right in here, you'll see that this was a big area where crypto.com has seen some reactions in the past, okay? And this is probably the only generally relevant area of support as of right now for crypto.com, and we actually saw that in this price action right in here. So we're still in this level of support, in my opinion. If we take a look at the 4-hour RSI, we'll see that we are trading below the 50, so that's not necessarily a great sign. But nonetheless, we like to take a look at price action over everything else. And if we take a look at the RSI, or if we take a look at the Fibonacci retracement of this most recent swing high right in here, we'll see that we've really not done that much, right? We're sitting at the 50% Fibonacci retracement to around the 61.8 Fibonacci retracement, which, if you don't know, is actually a very, very strong zone as far as Fibonacci retracements are concerned. So this little subsection right in here is a very strong turning point for most trends. And I am fully expecting a recovery very, very soon here on crypto.com. Obviously, nothing is impossible. We could definitely see a retest of this little zone right in here. But for right now, I am bullish on crypto.com in this area. And if we take a look at crypto.com compared to something like Bitcoin, right in here, okay, we're going to see that they are awfully correlated. Okay, they pretty much are moving in the exact same way. I wish it would show it better. Maybe we can get rid of all the drawings. Okay, when Bitcoin goes down, crypto.com goes down. I mean, the charts are very, very similar. You can see this is Bitcoin, this is crypto.com, and we are somewhat bearish on Bitcoin, somewhat bullish. So I'm going to be very interested in seeing what crypto.com does, see if we can break away from this Bitcoin correlation. Who knows what's going to happen next? I'm bullish on crypto.com. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to smash up that like button and subscribe and hit the bell notification icon if you're new. If you want to stay up to date with the latest and greatest cryptocurrency technical analysis and be a part of the trader troops. And if you want to improve your own trading and let me teach you everything I know about trading, check out the Measuring Markets program, link in the description down below. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.